Right, 9 June 2020, and today I want to announce the closure of two of our newspapers, so two of our online newspapers, that is maputoupdates.com and harareupdates.com. This has been a strategic decision that we made because of the changes that have been brought about by the coronavirus. So if you look before the coronavirus, we had a certain strategy, but now we have to rethink that strategy. Gambakwe Media runs four online newspapers that all of you are aware of, and two of those were exploratory or experimental newspapers that we put in place in 2019 to see how we can branch off from Gambakwe. At the time, Gambakwe was employing 20 people or more, including contractors, full-time employees, students, and interns. At the moment, we've drastically reduced the number of people that work at Gambakwe Media, and we do not plan to expand. Instead, we plan to focus, so to have a focused set of newspapers, mainly Gambakwe Media. This is where we're going to be doing most of our work. You know that our YouTube channel was attacked last year, so we lost one of our biggest revenue streams, and also traffic from Zimbabwe has been drastically affected by the cost of data. When we started out, to buy 1 gig of data was probably below $50. At the moment, the cheapest bundle of data that people buy in Zimbabwe, which is 25 gig, costs $1,300. And we have seen the impact of that from our Zimbabwe newspapers. There's been a big drop. So, for example, if our newspaper Harare Updates used to have 30,000 visitors a day, we are probably down right now to 1,000 visitors a day. There's also the issue of more newspapers that have appeared in Zimbabwe. The space is very, very active. There are more newspapers publishing the same things that we publish, so obviously won't have as much traffic as before. And as we're not funded, it's very difficult for us to continue to run a newspaper that is not profitable, paying employees, paying IT costs. So we run servers, we run a lot of other costs related to news gathering. So it becomes difficult for us to justify having a newspaper that is costing us more than what we're getting from it. And then also in terms of focus, it takes a lot of time from my attention. So I have to attend to it instead of focusing on other things. So that is the reason for Harare Updates. When it goes to Maputo Updates, I had a strategy of us going into Mozambique. Last year, I visited Mozambique and everything seemed to be fine. And what happened is, during the year, there started to be the unrest in Mozambique, and we have to start rethinking that strategy. Is being in Mozambique the right thing? Will we be able to go and move around under the current situation where there is unrest? Also, with the coronavirus, it's very difficult to move around. So if you're in South Africa, you can't go to Mozambique quickly, and it's difficult to report news when you're not on the ground. And Mozambique is a Portuguese market. You need to be on the ground to develop the people that are going to produce the news. And at the moment, it's not possible for me to quickly move around to Mozambique. So the Mozambique strategy is totally dead. We're not going to be going into Mozambique. I'm not going to personally going to be moving into Mozambique. I had said I'll be leaving in Mozambique, but that is not going to happen for safety reasons. Obviously, I won't be able to stay there if there is a rebellion or a war taking place. So those are some of the reasons why we've decided to end maputoupdates.com, and also the reasons for harareupdates.com. I also want to speak about the work that we have been doing at Gambakwe Media. The newspapers, the media house has grown. We have managed to get a lot of attention in terms of the news that we produce, and that is very, very exciting. We've also been covering very important stories, especially developments in the MDC, the coronavirus, all the issues, the political issues that are happening in Zimbabwe. I'm very happy with the coverage that we've been giving. I'm also very happy that we're contributing to employment in the media industry. So if you're running a newspaper in Zimbabwe, you're helping a lot. There are hundreds of people right now who have a media degree who don't have a job. I wish and hope that someone who runs an online media house will be able to employ the young people. It is very difficult to say after you finish your degree, you don't have a job. So I hope that the situation improves. Then we can restart some of our projects and we employ more people. As I said, at the height of Gambakwe Media, we employed 20 people and our payroll was above 40,000 rands. So this is what I'm saying. In Zimbabwe, that's a lot of money. I know that in other countries, that's not a lot of money. But in Zimbabwe, if someone is paid 2,000 rands, that's a lot of money, but the situation has changed. So we're not able to continue with most of the people that we're employing. I also want to look at the maturity of the media industry in Zimbabwe. The industry is not very mature. We don't have a lot of outstanding media figures. We need more media figures, but there are a lot of threats in the space. And the biggest threat is political actors coming out trying to destroy small media houses or trying to influence small media houses. We recently had a situation here last week where members of G40 were trying to make us publish a certain story. They relentlessly tried for 2 weeks to give us documents that, when I tried to verify, they did not want to give us that chance to verify those documents. And when we finally didn't publish at the time when they did, they went out in public and tried to damage our image, which was very unfortunate. We know the people who could say it right now, who they are and what they did, but that's not my character. So when I talk to someone in private, I never reveal the contents of a private discussion, even for fallout. So if you deal with me, and then don't expect that one day I'll turn around on you and produce the information that we discussed. That's not part of what I do, because our job relies on information. So I'm going to keep confidentiality, even if we're not friends anymore. So this is the situation. So that's it. A quick update. Two of our newspapers, online newspapers, MaputoUpdates.com, HaraldeUpdates.com, we're shutting them down. We are wrapping up and winding up as we speak. Last year we did very, very well. We hit more than 1 million hits or views on HarareUpdates.com, but the situation has just changed. The entertainment industry in Zimbabwe has been affected a lot by the shutdown. So let's see what happens after the lockdown, after coronavirus, probably in January. We'll see how we approach the entertainment industry. Right, thank you very much for watching. If you're watching this on WhatsApp, please send to as many people as possible. If you're watching this on YouTube and Facebook, please like, comment, and share.